Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand.
Now in the settings center, you will find a majority of the JAWS settings, such as reading web pages and PDFs, using forms mode, again, those speech settings, convenient OCR. So there's just a lot of different settings. You can also access your last changed settings, which I'm going to show you how to do. I like that feature a lot. It's very handy. If you know you changed something yesterday, for example, and you want to change it again today, change it back to something else, you can easily find it there. Now, in Settings Center, you have categories. And if you know the category that you're looking for, you can use first letter navigation. For example, I can press L for last changed settings, which I'll do here in just a second. So to get to the Settings Center, we're going to press Insert J once again to go to the JAWS window, just like we've been doing. U, Uniform, that's for Utilities menu. And then E, Echo, for the Settings Center. So once again,
with desktop folder view,
I'm going to press Insert J.
JAWS context menu.
U.
U, voice assistant submenu.
And E.
E, context menu, leaving menu bar, folder view, list view, zoom text 2021-31.
This is reading something on my desktop there, but I can press Insert T.
Title is JAWS Settings Center Default All Applications.
Okay, so I'm in the JAWS Settings Center. Now, when you go to it here, this places you in the default settings. There is also a way to get to Settings Center for an individual application. And Rachel's going to talk more about this stuff here in just a few minutes. But if you're in Microsoft Word, for example, and you press Insert and the number 6 on the number row, and you can do this from within applications like Google Chrome, Edge, Microsoft Word, you will get specific settings for that application. And at any time within those specific application settings, you can press Control Shift and the letter D, Delta, to switch back to the default settings for all applications. Now, there are some settings that must be changed within the default. For example, Voice Assistant is one of those. So if you're searching for a setting and you happen to be in the application specific settings and you search for a setting and you find it, you'll get a message that says that you need to press Control Shift D to go to your switch to your default and change that setting. But here we are in the default settings in Settings Center. And the first thing we have here is a search box. So let's go ahead and type Voice Assistant and see what we get.
VOICE space ASISTANT. Voice Assistant, one of three search results.
Okay, now I can just down arrow here.
Three search results list box, Voice Assistant, use the arrow keys to select.
And here we have Voice Assistant. If I go down again.
Enable Voice Assistant checked. Voice.
That's checked, so I know mine is enabled.
Enable Voice Assistant sounds checked.
And the sounds are checked. So let's go back up to where it says Voice Assistant. And I'm going to press Enter.
Enter, search edit box cleared.
And I'm going to down arrow. Now, if we had not, I'll show you this in a minute. If we had not used the search box, you could also just down arrow and start navigating through those settings.
Window
all of the settings here.
Window classes closed. Voice Assistant closed.
So now here we are in the actual settings, and it took me to Voice Assistant because that's what I typed in, but we can up and down arrow through these different categories. So these are closed. If you want to open one, you can press the right arrow key to expand it.
Voice Assistant open.
And then you can down arrow through the changes, or not changes, through the settings, I'm sorry.
Level 1, enable voice assistant checked.
And we have enable.
Listen for wake word Sharky checked.
Listen for the wake word.
Enable voice assistant sounds checked.
Enable the sounds.
Take me to the privacy policy.
And here.
Level 0, window classes.
And when you hear it say a different level, then you know you're on to the next category. So I'm going to go back up into this voice assistant category.
Level.
And if I want to collapse it, I can hit left arrow. You press right arrow to expand it, left arrow to collapse it.
Level 0, voice assistant, L, last changed settings closed.
Okay, so last changed settings closed. So when you make changes and save them, you will see them here in last changed settings. It saves the last 25 that changes that you've made. So I'm going to press right arrow to open this.
Last changed settings opened.
And I can down arrow here through these changes.
Level 1, enable mouse echo not checked.
So that was one of the changes I unchecked. And if I wanted to check it, I could press space.
Space, check.
And if I knew I changed it, you know, for example, like I said yesterday, I could just go back and change it now. It's an easy way to get to it without having to search for it. or I could go down here.
Navigation, quick keys, keyboard.
And I'm just using, I'm using my down arrow key to navigate.
Navigation, quick keys, keyboard, general under and say all only.
And those are just a couple of the changes. So now that we've made a change here, I'm going to go back. I'm going to collapse this group. I want to show you one more thing before we exit Settings Center.
Last change, settings closed.
So now I'm on a category, and if I tab, I get this box.
Read only edit. This group contains the last 25 options that were recently changed for an application. When you select an item in the tree view, its corresponding settings. Use your reading keys.
And I could just use my down arrow to continue reading the dialogue in this box. It explains about how this category works. And any category that you're on, whether it's web, forms mode, whatever it may be, if you press tab while you're on that category, even if it's closed, you'll get this description here in this box. So now I'm going to press tab again.
Apply button to that.
Now we have an apply button, and we also have an OK button. But if you make a change here in Settings Center, you want to press space on the apply button first.
Space, tree view.
And then we'll tab to OK.
Read only OK button.
And press space again.
Space, desktop.
And now we're back on our desktop. And that is a demonstration of Settings Center. Now, if you're in Settings Center and you want to close it without making any changes, you can also press escape to do that.
Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand. To stay up to date on upcoming webinars and training events, complete the sign-up form at freedomscientific.com/webinars. Thanks again for connecting with us.